Hello guys, so we're gonna do different shape on the hand. So let's under show menu turn off everything and then show only polygon and NURB surface, not CV, sorry, NURB surface, so that we don't see those controller. And I'm gonna template this. You can either template or you could referencing. So either way, I'm gonna template because I don't want to see it. I just want to see the outline. And I'm gonna start with a box modeling. Turn on move. Here we go. Move in place. And we're gonna build symmetrical, something simple. So under cube, I'm gonna divide it into I think the height is y, I'm gonna do 2. Oops, sorry, not that shape, the subdivision. Here we go. And the center is x. Here we go. So that 2, just only at this moment, just that's it. And I'm gonna scale this up so that they form a little shape like the hair. Right click and choose control vertex, and then you just sculpt a little bit, get the overall shape. Here we go. And you might need to go to side view, and if those are interfere, you might need to do show non, show NURB surface, show polygon. Here we go. Up NURB surface guy, not curve. I keep doing that. There we go. So, and I'm gonna just build. Here we go. And how about I do kind of like this? Okay. Actually, I changed my mind. This is good. And then I'm gonna select the face right there. I turn on symmetry, sorry, I forgot. Hey guys, let me undo. No. I don't know why I need to undo. I forgot to tell you. Under modeling toolkit here, just leave it on. I turn on symmetry, object X. So when I grab one side, I move both left and right. Okay. So, and now I'm going to extrude this. Shift right mouse click, extrude face, and then just push it. Extrude the wrong side, guys. Hold on. Right here. And extrude, shift right mouse click, extrude face, or you can do that from there. So now, right now, here we go. And basically, I want it to form this direction. I didn't do it well. Hold on. Let me move that. Here we go. Okay. All right. So, and I'm going to move this side down a little bit, try to make it look kind of round. So, under show menu, non surface, and polygon. Here we go. So, and I think I can move this wider. That one can be a little less. Here we go. Okay, so it looked like this. And look at on top view, you have to do all full view, show non, show surface, and polygons. So I need to move this backward a little bit so that look like this. Can you see? Here we go. Okay, and this can be inward. That can be in a little. Here we go. So, and look like this. Okay. And I think I need to subdivide this. Multi-cut, hold control key, and use middle mouse click to assign the loop on the center. Okay. Try to keep it uniform. Trim that down a little bit and these can be, I try to make it round shape. Can you see right here? Okay. And we can actually add a little more section there too. Let me cut this area first. Multi-cut, we need a little more. Here we go. It's just because we're gonna build the eye socket. So right there, eye socket. Now with the eye socket, I need to create concave separately, so I cannot use symmetry, turn it off. So I have to do, you can hold shift select both and extrude face, but keep face together off, and I'd like you to just offset it. Can you see? Like an eye. There we go. And I'm gonna move up, switch to normal and scale. Oh, sorry. Oh, no. You can't do that. So just let go, select both, and then just scale. No, scale doesn't look good, guys. So maybe just shift right mouse, turn on a symmetry bar, and just use move to move. So that they are a little closer. I'm not going to do too technical on modeling. So here we go. And then you can select extrude again and push inward. There we go. So now you get the eye socket. I'm gonna rotate a little like that. Can you see? Okay. And if I press 3, it will look like this. Okay. So I don't expect anything to be complicated. This is good. And I'm gonna turn on move. So I can subdivide them a little bit. So I'll go to object mode, shift right mouse click, and choose smooth. Just a little bit. Here we go. So you got something there. And let's bring the eyeball, see if it show up. I think that's good. You can sculpt the surface around a little bit too. So I'm gonna let go for now. There we go. Actually, they are a little lower. So let's change, fix a little bit. I should have done that before I smooth, but shift click. Here we go. Okay, turn on move to and just move it down so that they kind of a little match with the eyeball. I'm gonna scale up. I'm gonna turn on move to and just move aside. I might have to rotate a little bit like this. Here we go. Okay. Stylized, guys, not like a. And now the nose, if you want it, that's not difficult at all. So multi-cut, I'm going to spread this a little bit. I'm going to cut like this. There we go. And then connect this. Now, it's okay to have four corners, guys, three corners, because we are not doing a for modeling class. We just try to modify it. So I'm not expecting like a real good model. So, well, still good, but not like it's super good. What should I say? It's not for grading. No, it's great. Sorry, I don't know what I'm saying. What I mean is it's not a modeling class, so you just do as much as you can. And so that they looks a little unique. That's all. Here we go. So it does look unique. There we go. And what I'm doing this is I did not plan at all what shape. I just do it because I want to show you that you can come up with the idea really quickly by just playing around with your with the geometry. Okay. I think let me move that down. Oh, both of them more. Okay. This can go over. That's good enough. Okay. And if you want to have a nozzle, just extrude this. Yeah. And now this time you have to do one at a time though, because left and right, let me turn off the symmetry quick. Uh-oh. What am I doing here? Yeah. Turn that off. Temporary. Select. There you go. Extrude first. But offset first. Let's offset 0.1. 0.05. 0.1 is too big. So 0.05. Actually, I can do 0.03. No, 0.07. The shape started to look awkward, so no. 0.06 might be okay. Yeah, let me try to scale it down. No. Okay, let me try again. So extrude it again. So 0.06, right? Extrude again. Now I can push inward. And I can uniformly scale. Okay. So it looks like a little weird shape, but you got an idea. So now on this side, though, I'm going to do the same. Extrude. I already know that offset will be 0.06. There we go. And then I'm going to extrude it again. Hold shift. Extrude. And this time you're going to push in and then scale it. There we go. Okay. It's not uniform now. It's okay. We can re-mirror it if you want. So now I'm going to turn this back on symmetry. And I'm going to turn on move to. And just move in. Make this adjustment a little bit right there. Okay, that's good enough. So I'm gonna move this forward. There we go. Okay. And let me take a look at on the side view. We can make this bottom part straight by turn on scale 2 and just scale like this. And you can rotate a little bit. I'm gonna extend like this. There we go. Rotate a little more. And that's it. So, and if this is too small, just move it a little bit. And I'm gonna grab the whole thing here. And just scale non-uniform. Here we go. Okay, here we go. And so that's the top of the face. So now, and I can go back to here, the layer mask. I'm gonna reuse this. I'm not going to build the head. So now the head, I already saved in different menu. So this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna grab that. Delete history, Alt Shift D, delete history, and face transform. I'm gonna call new skull. How about a SKNW new skull? Here we go. Face transformation, modify face it. And now I'm gonna just replace this skull. So basically, you just select that right there. You can do minimize, drag, and drop. Can you see right here is a head joint. So I'm going to drop on the head joint. Here we go. And then I can remove this. You can do a backup or you can delete. That's fine. Delete it. Here we go. So I just delete it. And now I did I fix transform? Let me disconnect again. Oh, here we go. Oh, I did. So in that case, I'm gonna just undo, go back. Here we go. Can you see? And you can modify them more or whatever you like to do at this point. And modify just a little bit because I want it to look a little better on the eyes. Here we go. Okay. Right there. Here we go. And maybe let's move this part over. And if I switch to full, you will see what I'm selecting. I didn't select correctly that one. Press 5 back. And here we go. And let's see what else. Maybe I should move this inward. Here we go. Oh no. That one has to be forward. Because it doesn't look good. And here we go. So now I can modify this. We don't have to sculpt a new one. So this one, I'm gonna just isolate quick. Control 1. Under show menu, isolate, view selected, control 1. Okay. So I'm gonna remove his teeth and reshape this a little bit. I don't like that. I want straight cut. Now to do straight cut, this is easy. So I'm gonna get rid of that, delete it, and delete this face too. Here we go. So now this is what I want you to do. Shift right mouse click and choose append to polygon 2. I thought it would be right here, it's not. So we have to go to mesh 2, append to polygon. That's it. So click there and the opposite. It's four corner, press Y, click this and that because it's four corner. And then there and there. Here we go. And somehow symmetrical doesn't work on this. How is that possible? Oh, did I turn it off? That's weird. Doesn't work on this at all. So well, just do twice. Press Y. Y is repeat the 2. Repeat the 2, yes. Here we go. So now it's back. And now same thing as here. This is going to be a little easier. You just select, shift double click, hit delete, select that, hit delete, shift select, double click, hit delete. Delete again. Oop. Hold shift, double click. Hold on. We might have to redo. Here we go. Shift, double click. Select first and then shift, double click. And then now we can delete all. And right here, you could just fill hole. Go to object mode. Shift, right mouse click, fill hole. There we go. And if you want, you can remove the edge. So right now, we are on edge, right? So shift right mouse click, delete edges. Ouch! Nope, it's not. So just leave it there. It's not going to be anything that much. Control 1 to bring, not much geometry. Let's show isolate or uncheck view selection. So now I'm going to have to sculpt a little bit. I'm going to move this top part to be a little higher. Okay. So, you know, might be a good idea, guys, to move those. Control 1 again. Sorry. It's just because otherwise you have to select so many spots here. This is what you can do. You can select the face like this. Okay. And go to selection. Invert selection, not inverse, oh, convert, sorry, convert convert selection to edge. And then you can shift right mouse click, delete edges. So now it's nice and clean. Okay. So control one to bring everything back. And I'm gonna just grab one, two faces there and just move it up higher. That's all. So see, it's not that difficult. Go to side view. And if you want it to be straight line, turn on scale 2 and then just scale it. And then scale 1 direction. Rotate it. Gonna move forward a little bit. There we go. See that? And now this section, we're gonna reposition a little bit. Just I'm gonna go to side view, grab only those. Now double click on a move to turn on soft selection. But I'd like you to choose surface, not volume. And to increase the fall off, you can hold B key with middle mouse button. And just increase the fall off. Now on the side view, I'm gonna move inward. I just want to hide. Here we go. Right there. And I can go backward a little bit if I want to. I can rotate if I need to. Here we go. So right there. So that I can see. Now hold B key again and undo. Sorry. Hold B key with middle mouse drag. So that increases a little more fall off of deformation. How about that? Okay. And I actually don't like this part at all. It's okay. You don't have to. Let me press B key to turn off. Then I can move only one ring. Here we go. Okay. I think that's okay. And what about this shape? Yeah. Okay. So I'm gonna reduce more section. I'm gonna keep that one. I'm not keeping this. I'm gonna skip one line there. How about that? Delete edge. Here we go. Let me see if I can remove this area. Shift right mouse click, delete. Here we go. So now see, it's different now. And I can right click. SI existing material, just use Lambert one, so that is a, or you can use different Lamberts, up to you. This one looks weird. I want Lambert one, here we go. So, now see, now they are different. And this part, you can leave it there, it's fine, or you can change something. Like right here, I can create a new cylinder. The arm. How about the leg? Let's do the leg. Well, no. Let me do the arm. So that kind of try to put it in one spot. So I can do 12. And I am not going to turn on cap. Here we go. And radius. A little smaller. Like that. Rotate. You might need to look at on front view. Press F. I think I should type it in 90. There we go. Go ahead and move it. I'm gonna just move in spot first. Okay. And don't freeze transform yet because we wanted to modify them. So now I'm gonna make the height a little longer. See if it fit. You might need to press 4. Okay, all right. Now I'm gonna add division now. Division height, about just simple like this. Okay, and at this point, I'm gonna go to vertex, grab these two vertices, and I'm gonna just scale it like this. So basically, I want those to be right there. Here we go, right there. Okay, and select the face. Oh, be careful, because they are overlap. So let me template that. Here we go. Select faces right here, and we're gonna extrude it. So shift right mouse click, extrude face, and then just make it look like this. Here we go. See, something simple, doesn't have to be complex. And okay, so now I think I'm gonna make this ring a little wider right there. One, two. You can, I am I it doesn't work on the symmetry edge, I think, because let me switch to object Y. Has to be on Y because we rotate 90 degrees. Can you see right there? Now it's select on that side. If I switch to 4, you will see, because I switch to Y, and I can scale like this. Okay. So, and now, if I press 5, here we go, I can round the edge a little bit. Right now, I'm just do it quick. So, when you do on your own, you can take your time. Shift right mouse click and bevel edge. Here we go. So round, then you can increase fraction if you like. And if you want it to be even more curved, you can add segment. So now, can you see a little curve there? I don't think it's necessary, but it's fine. There we go. So, and now we're gonna have to replace, but before that, let's duplicate this. So, now I'm gonna phase transform, modify phase it. There we go. To duplicate, and Alt Shift D to delete it. Okay, and then you can name like a forearm. So that one will be a SKR form. Okay. And mesh or poly, something like that. So now we're going to duplicate it. Control D. And I'm going to just rename to L. And to move it to the other side, you need a little help. Group it to itself. Control G. When I turn on move to, can you see? Hold on, let me undo quick. So turn on move to so that you can see the pivot point. Now when I group it to itself, the pivot point shift here. So we can do -1. And then right here, ungroup. You need to do ungroup, otherwise you can leave the group node there. And then you're gonna modify phase it. And that's it. So, and you can just keep continue left, right. Now fingers, if too much, you can just keep that those fingers as is. It's okay. So, but it's totally up to you. Okay. So now, this is already a child, but it's outside of this mesh. So I'm gonna add. Here we go. So now when we template it, it will be gone too. So at this point, we're gonna remove this. Okay. You select that and find it where it is on outliner. You gotta find it first so that you can replace them. There we go. So right there. Oh, it's humerus. So I didn't call forearm. So this is what you need to do. I'm gonna collapse something. The right side, right? So I'm gonna move that and drop. This is a child of the shoulder joint, so we're going to drop it there. And then you're going to remove this. So that's what you need to do. Okay. So same thing as here, you select first. And let me collapse this. Oops, we select. So that we know where it is. There we go. Right there. So select this one and the humerus. I think I should name humerus too. I'm gonna move that and drop it under shoulder joint. And then I'm going to remove this. Let me rename that. Yes. Okay. Hit delete. And I'm going to rename that. Yes. Okay. So I'm going to also do this one too. And where is that one? Right there. Just rename it. You don't have to, but I like to do it. There we go. Let me save this as. That's in as. I'm going to call rigs 6. How about save new mesh. Okay. So basically I'm replacing. And this is how I do it. And now for the ribcage, you don't have to do like this at all. You could just one single surface and then you deform them. Or you could, let me think quick. I could sculpt in a new, let's do that. Let's do that. Okay. So, and this time though, I'm not going to do piece by piece like this, but I'm going to do one surface and then you're going to skin it. Okay. Skin it. Okay. Let me see if this is all right. Okay. So one last thing I'm going to show it to you on this part. Okay. And you don't have to do it. You can just keep them. And when you form the new shape, you just form the shape that kind of similar style to the organic shape of the skull. Let me remove this. I can't stop thinking about it. Sorry. Here we go. Because that's make more like it. Okay. Let me see if I can delete this one too. Nah. Wait. I do. Just delete it again. There's a reason. Because I want to bevel this instead. Bevel it. Then make fraction a little larger. Yeah. See if I can do 2. Yes. Oh, no. 1. Because it's overlapping. Okay. I think it's because of that. Okay. Hold on. That's all. I can't do more than that. Unless I move this part. Make it thicker. Okay, so I'm gonna just let it go. Because otherwise I would keep doing it. I won't stop. Okay, so here we go. Save your file again. Now on this part, I'm gonna look at on side view. Started with cube again. Because it's easier. Cube. And I'm gonna make it larger. Okay. And let's do longer. Here we go. That's it. And subdivision height 1 unit. And we want symmetry, right? So we gotta do another unit. I just highlight the label, and then middle mouse drag on screen to increase the section. I think I need on the side too. One more. Here we go. No. Too much work. Okay. And then I'm going to just grab, turn on symmetrical. Oh, go to a modeling toolkit. Object X this time. So I want it to be a little round shape. Okay. So I move like that. And let's look at on the side one. Let me move like this first. I want it round. There we go. And I'm gonna move the whole thing backward, forward, rotate a little. You might need to change to template. But here we go. Because that might be interrupting your eyeball. And I'm gonna just try to make the shape similar to the ribcage. That's all. Let me scale that down. Okay. And before we move forward, I'm gonna grab that, push in a little bit. Okay. Move that a little bit in. Now I see that I was actually do need one section here. That's okay. Okay. Well, let's round these out. Just go to object mode and then just go to smooth, shift right mouse click, smooth a little bit. Yeah. So now if it's too soft, I think under continuity, you can put 0 and change this to linear so that they won't be too smooth, too soft and that's okay. So now I'm gonna make a little adjustment. Select that. Press B to turn on soft selection. B, hold B and middle mouse drag. Oh, come on. Let me turn on move too quick. Middle mouse drag to increase fall off. And then just move it down a little bit forward. Let me scale a little bit more. Okay. Let's bring this backward even more. Okay. So, and I would, you could just keep it like this shape or something like that. Okay. Let me scale a little bit. Okay. I should stop. Otherwise, I'm gonna keep doing it. And now I could hollow this. Press B to turn off, hit delete, and then I'm gonna extrude it. Extrude. Now, if you move forward like this, might be too thick, I don't know. And then I could add something in there. Okay, so right now, we need to focus on one thing. Under show menu, turn on skeleton. Oh no, joint. Joints right there. There's a reason that I want you to turn on joints. Gonna press 4. And this one show joints. Okay. We need to figure out the section here. Can you see 1, 2? I want you to slide multi-cut, hold control key. And you need to subdivide them to match those joint section there. Here we go. I'm gonna subdivide up. There's a reason, because this will make things a little easier when you do paint skin with. Here we go. Now let's remove some that line and control delete. Here we go. Now I did it too soon. We need to match them, the inside also. Otherwise, inside will come out, will penetrate it. So I did it too soon. So let's, can you do this? Click, shift, double click, hit delete, click inside, hit delete. Now you go to object mode Shift right mouse click, extrude. This time I want you to extrude backward. It's just because otherwise we'll be too outward, too thick on the outside. And then you go to object mode. You need to go to this mesh display and reverse the normal. Here we go. So now when we get like this, it will skin a lot easier. Okay, so delete history, control shift delete, face transformation, here we go, and name torso or something like that. SK and torso mesh. Okay, so on torso mesh, you're gonna have to skinning it. Okay, so I could keep that geometry and I'm gonna remove all the torso. So I'm gonna, let's go to full. You might need to hide this. Let's go to object mode. Let's put temporary inside one layer. So hide it. Okay. And now I'm gonna just delete this. Now, you don't want to delete this yet. You need to use the command to detach the skin first. Okay. Hold on, let me delete this quick. Okay. We don't want that anymore. Okay. So now, select the surface. You might need to check this first. Select the joint and go to change the module to rigging and skeleton. Oh no, we already skinned, right? So under skin, go to bipose. Okay, you have to see this. If you see an error, it means you need to zero out your curve. There might be volumes because those are on the initial width, right? When we skin width, that's what it is. So I can uncheck. So now after you go to bypass, you can do skin unbind, and then I'm gonna delete. We need to remove the bind information away, and so now I'm gonna bring this back. And I'm gonna skin it. So you select the surface, and this time we want it to skin right only that part. So you can hold shift select. Oh, not that one, sorry. You want it from here. Because you can do the whole root actually, like all the root there. But I think it's too much. Let me even go with this. That's it. Here we go. And then you go to skin, bind skin, open up option. I'm gonna reset it quick. You want a join hierarchy because that what I will select join. Okay. And allow multiple bind posts on. This let's do only 3. Maintain max inference, no bind skin. Here we go. And test. When you go to a show curve, let's bend this. See if the surface bent correctly. Here we go. Can you see? So now this is a little too much. You know what? I think this is not a good bind. Let's unbind quick. So skin unbind. I want you to re-select to the base. Let's make it all the way to the base right there, the base joint. And let's just make it something simple. Bind skin hierarchy. Bring that to 5 so that we don't have to touch up so much. So now, here we go. So you can't crash too hard because, so this is it. And here we go. Can you see? So it's mean on the top, you can't crash too hard. This is the maximum you want to go. Okay. So because you don't want it to punctuate like this. There we go. And let me show CV curve. Here we go. Let's crunch it more. Here we go. That would work. Okay. So now it's follow. Here we go. Okay, that's it. I just want you to make something simple. It doesn't have to be too complex. So I'm gonna put it back to zero. And I think that's it. The rest of them, you just go ahead, take your time to edit them as need. I mean, you don't have to replace everything. Just make it a little different. And you can change different color, stuff like that. So Lambert 1, here we go. And now I'm going to show only polygon. I can select all the polygon, right mouse click, assign existing Lambert 1. So, whoops, that one. I do not know why I'm using that. Oh, I know what it is. It's just because it belongs to outside of the layers. If I add into it, will be the same. So, that one too. Okay. And you can get rid of this layer when you're done. Okay. So, that's it for now. And you get an idea already how to modify the surface. I don't want to drag it too long because it's the same technique to sculpt them. Okay, save.